sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. You are the living word, bread
of heaven,
sent down from glory.
Sent down from glory.
Many things.
You are the living word, the Jesus.
song in that. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Oh, that was good.
Oh, my God. Jesus.
You might as well enjoy yourself. You hear me? Can I get a witness? I tell you, when I used to go into the club, I said, get ready now. They said, Ronnie's here. Uh-oh. Can I get a witness in here? And he said, hey, yeah, Ronnie's in here. The party gonna go up a little higher now. But I found out there ain't no party like the Holy Ghost party, because the Holy Ghost party don't stop. Oh. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness? I don't know about you. Sometimes I just can't hold my seat. Isn't that right? Now see, this gospel music and secular music, the temptations, I move. Did you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Sliding and finding stones, I move.
Yeah.
Oh, come on now, all right. The OJs, I move. Now the praise team, abundant life, you ought to move a little bit. Can I get a witness? All right. I'm so glad, brothers and sisters. The joy of the Lord is my strength. I got a feeling some people ain't gonna, they not gonna be happy. Because heaven is a lively place. It's a praise and worship place. Isn't that right? These people don't like church. Guess what? If you don't like church, I'm serious, you may not want to go to heaven. Because it's gonna be one Holy Ghost party. Amen. Well, we're going to have to look at our clock. Our time, how long, amen? Can I get a witness? You can tell a lot of folks don't like church. But I'm going to fit right on in. Isn't that right? Because I got a grandmama over there, amen? Got some uncles over there. Got an uncle over there I ain't seen yet. Isn't that right? Talking about some Holy Ghost dancing. Oh, Lord. All right, here we go. Gotta see my Jesus. That's another. Oh, shout about
it.
All right. Okay. I'm gonna be brief today. It's men's day. Holy Spirit wanna talk to you, and he wanna talk to me. Talk to all us men today. And women, you get a little taste of it too. Amen. But men, I'll get ready. Amen. Some of the best sermons that the Lord let me preach is I'm preaching to myself. Can I get a witness? I heard the Holy Spirit tell me once, he said, Ronnie, it goes for you too. It ain't just for them. It's for you too. I said, okay, Lord. Because it is God that worketh in me both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Sometimes the Lord, why you call me? That you call me. You could have called anybody else. I swear. But he did. So I'm here because he sent me. Can I get a witness again? One thing that I can tell you that I know for certain, that Jesus is alive. And he is a miracle worker. And this is Friday. God has his eyes on you and on me. Help me, Lord. Look to the person next to you. God has his eyes on you and me. Scary, ain't it? I repent, Lord. Forgive me, Lord. I'm so sorry. Somebody do some repenting around me. Forgive me, God, in Jesus' name. I done repented already, you know, but it's good to do it as much as you can. Can I get a witness? If you have a Bible, I want you to open it up to the book that is entitled Jeremiah, chapter 17. I want you to look at verse 7.
Get ready.
If you got a program, I got it written on the program for you. If you got it written on the program, I don't want to write it on the program every Sunday, because if I do that, some of you won't just stop bringing your Bible, and you need to bring your Bible with you. That's why I don't print it every Sunday on the program. When you got it, say, thank you, Jesus. So I know, God, you're going to bless me with this word today. And if you need it, say, Lord, I need it. Some of us need it. Lord, let the anointing fall now. Jeremiah 17 and 7, if you got a program, and I'm going to read it off the program, it says, blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord, whose hope the Lord is. Yeah. Blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is. Jeremiah said that. The next scripture I want you to look at. The book that is entitled The Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, reading verse 22. It's also on your printed program. When you have found it, say hallelujah. Like what Betty said, thank you, Jesus. Thank God, a good God. The Holy Spirit gets your attention and my attention when I read these words. Acts 13, verse 22. And when he had removed him, he raised up unto them David to be that king, to whom also he gave their testimony and said, I have found David, the son of Jesse, a man after my own heart, which shall fulfill all my will. Stop right there. Read any more. The subject that God has given me to talk to you about today is a real man. A real man. There are some men, they are not really real. They are imitation men. They have the gender. Amen. They have the physical, genetic makeup. They even have the physique and the voice. But they are really not men. Can I get a witness in here? There are a lot of men that are perpetrating as men, but they are just boys. Can I get a witness? They are very childish, very immature, very irresponsible. Have mercy, Lord. Amen. They like to play, but they don't like to pay. Can I get a witness in here? Ladies, I apologize to you if you have married a boy. Can I get a witness? There are times people marry for the wrong reasons. Are y'all with me? You see, when mama picked up everything behind them and cleaned up everything behind them, they expect you to act like they mama. Can I get a witness again? responsibility. Are y'all with me here?
Amen.
A real man knows that he is accountable for how he handled family matters and how he handled situations. Can I get a witness? When the going get rough, he don't run, but he just get tough. Ain't God a good God? I gotta be honest, I like being a man. I remember when I was a boy, I was looking at myself in the mirror. Mama would harass me by telling me, I want you to do this, I want you to do that. I'll get that frown. I'll look in the mirror and say, I can't wait till I get grown. Can't wait till I get out of this house. Can't wait till I get my own car. Can't wait till I start shaving. I remember I used to get in the mirror and I used to pretend like I was shaving, didn't have nothing to shave. One of my pictures when I was in high school, I wanted a mustache so bad. Picture day was coming. So I painted me a mustache on my face. They said, son, do you know that you have painted a mustache on your face? I said, yes, I do. Something wrong with that boy. I took that picture with that mustache on. Mama, I don't know if you did or not, but I don't think Mama bought that picture. Oh, my God. Didn't understand that when God made me a man, he gave me power to have influence, to have impact. As a man in my community and in my environment. I like what that Spider-Man writer says, come with great power comes great responsibility. As a man, God has made us first. We are the head. And guess what? We have not done so much and accepted the responsibility as being the head of the planet, of the earth, of houses, land. Men, we ain't done such a good job. Amen. Can I get a witness? We have messed up a lot of things. And God is having to clean up a lot of the messes we done made. Can I get a witness in here? I've learned that a real man, he fixes problems, not make problems for somebody else to fix.
Hey, come on.
Can I get a witness? A real man. Somebody say a real man. Is willing to make sacrifices. Amen. Knowing the outcome is going to serve a greater purpose. I didn't grow up with my daddy in my house. I believe as I look at my daddy, now I'm not looking at your daddy, but I'm looking at my own daddy. My daddy was a poor role model as a man. So I can talk about my daddy. You know, he dead now, but I can still talk about it. The truth is the truth. Can I get a witness? My daddy would never tuck me in. My daddy would never read me stories. My daddy didn't, would never, when I started growing, had places that I didn't understand for me to ask him, Daddy, what this is all about. When I had a little girl, on a date a little girl, I couldn't talk to my daddy. How do I talk to that girl? How do I treat that girl? What should I say to that girl? Should I whoop that girl? Should I hit that girl? Should I try to control that girl?
No.
Somebody said, no. But I gotta tell you that there was some in the family, though, were men. If I'd have modeled myself after them, then guess what? I would do all them things that I should not have done. Can I get a witness? Thank God for somebody that's willing, even though they ain't your daddy, to try to train you and tell you what's right. Can I get a witness in here? But I learned from Jesus that he is a real role model for a man. Not only was he the Son of God, but he was a man. Jesus fixed problems. If that was something broke, Jesus fixed it. If that was somebody that needed praying for, he prayed. Thank God, a good God. When somebody need to learn a lesson in life, he would stop and give them a parable or a story or a narrative to try to get on their level. He wouldn't say, I ain't got time for them. I ain't got time for that.
That's right.
One thing I see in scripture that women, they gravitated from Jesus because he didn't treat them like some of us, we treat women. Can I get a witness in here? Jesus gave women what they should have from all of us who are men, and that is R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Tell me what it means to me. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. I've learned that if you can respect most women, they'll love you for it. Can I get a witness? Not all of them. Their song is beyond repair. Some women just crazy. Women, if you respect them like you would your mother or your sister or your grandmother or your auntie, you know, if you respect them like your own daughter, then most of them will love you. Can I get a witness? Jesus was forgiving. There are times when men, we have a problem with forgiving, but Jesus showed me as I look at him that a real man forgives. Can I get a witness? Scripture says Jesus was a lot like me. He had a human side. He was tempted like me. But like me, he didn't fall into temptation. He was stronger than I am. But he gave me power so that I can be strong too.
That's right.
Oh boy, I got quiet. Amen. That I can make better decisions when I got him living inside of me.
Amen.
Jesus fixed problems. He healed the sick. He opened the eyes of the blind. He gave hope. Men, are we giving hope to our daughters? Are we giving hope to others, siblings, daughters, our own male? Are we giving them hope that they can have a better future? That they can be empowered to make a difference, not only local, but international.
Yeah.
And they don't tell us how God can use them if they allow God to use them.
Right.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
We want our children to be better than us.
Yeah.
Thank God, a good God.
Yeah.
We don't want our children patting themselves after us.
No,
isn't that right? Watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this. Now, there are a lot of boys acting, trying to be like men. I said this earlier, they ain't real.
No.
When they come up, they think being high is cool.
Right.
They think cigarette. It's cool.
Yeah.
Really? Isn't that right? They think selling drugs is cool. Can I get a witness?
True.
They think being a drunkard. Oh man, that's cool. We got lit up now. Got lit up. They think that's cool. That's stupid and crazy. I don't judge nobody, but I don't like nobody looking at my underwear. I like to keep them guessing. What is he wearing? Sometimes these little boys, young men, I'm like, Lord, have mercy. Sometimes it don't look right. I'm like, I don't want to look at that. Now, if I'm going to show my underwear, I'm going to make sure they're clean. I don't want no stains on them. Lord, what is happening to our men? Our young, what? We are in a state of emergency. Refusing to live above the potential or the potential that God has set for them. And the reason why it is, I believe, I'm stopping with that man in the mirror. I'm asking him to change his way. I like that though.
It is true.
If men, we look in the mirror, we done messed up a lot of generations. Can I get a witness? Boy, got quiet. Man, I know I look. I'm repenting. I told you I'm still repenting. Thank God, a good God. When you look at the man in the mirror, you see that we are the cause of a lot of issues in the community. When young men, you can't hardly get them to church. You can get them in the barber shop, but you can't get them to church. You can get them in the club, but you can't get them to church. If we have a drag strip, you can get them to come and watch drag racing, but you can't get them. If LeBron was in, you can get them in the basketball court, but you can't get them in. It's hard to get young folk in the church. Can I get a witness? It's because, guess what, man? We don't go to church. And guess what? Because we don't go, we don't care if our children go or not. But that's messing your children up because it's gonna mess you up.
Come on.
I got to get ready to close here. I do. I really got to close here. But a real man, I learned from Jesus, fixed problems. He builds up. He's very unselfish. Ooh. He don't have to have everything his way. Isn't that right? He's forgiving and he's loving and he tries to be compassionate and kind and understanding. Although he's human, he is not perfect. He does go off sometimes. Sometimes he don't say what he ought to say and he don't do what he ought to do. But his heart is in the right place. Jesus taught me something about compassion. There was a woman that was caught. She was caught in the very act of adultery. Yeah. They brought her to Jesus. Mm-hmm. And the law said that she ought to be stoned to death.
That's right.
Because she was caught in the act of getting up.
Yeah.
But when they brought that woman to Jesus,
come on, man.
Man, look what Jesus said.
Jesus.
He that is among you, there are.
Yeah.
He that is among you without sin, I'm going to get him.
Yeah.
He that is without sin. And if you look at some of the narration, it is said that the girl had two children. And she was saying, the Hollywood version of it, she was saying, don't kill me. I got two children. I'm sorry. And that crowd would have it.
No.
Now, that's hard. I don't know if that's true or not, but we know she might have been somebody's mother. She might have been somebody's sister. We know she was somebody's daughter. We know she was a human being. We know that she was a person that had feelings. And we all make mistakes.
Yeah.
Anybody here ain't never made no mistake? Anybody here ain't never messed up? See, that may be somebody here. You might be perfect. And you may have a rock and you say, I stoned all them sinners. Them sinners. But Jesus said, guess what? He said, if you're gonna be forgiven by me, then you got to be willing to forgive others. So if you are here and you have sinned and I don't have forgave you, he said, cast the first stone, and the Bible says that. Everybody drop their rock.
Amen.
We're so quick to be judgmental. I admit some things is hard to forgive. But if I'm going to hang out with Jesus as my pop and my savior, he said, drop your rock, man. So I don't have no choice. I said, Lord, I may not drop it on Monday. I'll drop it on Tuesday. Drop your rock. I'll drop it next month. Drop your rock. I'll drop it next. Ain't God a good God? Jesus dealt with the problem of sin because we are all battling that flesh.
Amen.
That sinful flesh.
Yes.
Sometimes, Ernest, I ask myself, what's wrong with you? How come you think like that? Sometimes I ask myself, what's the matter? Then talk to myself, what's the matter with you? Don't you?
Yes, I do.
I know I shouldn't be thinking thoughts like this. Well, I know some of y'all said, what do you think? I ain't telling you a thing. I ain't saying nothing. None of your business. Can I get a witness? Lord, help me. Help me. Paul says, sometimes I do things that I don't do. He said, sometimes when I'm thinking about good, evil is always present, trying to get me to discredit Jesus.
Amen.
I was like, who shall save me?
Yeah.
Amen, Jesus. I'll save you.
Yes.
This is how God dealt with me on with mine. He said, you know what? He said, I know something. He said, I've been through what you don't went through. But he says, one of the things that you got to remember is some of the things you think on it, but you don't act on it. Can I get a witness? See, as long as you don't act on it, you're all right. Just don't act on those things that you know can shipwreck your relationship. Because when you act on those things, then guess what? Oh, you got a whooping coming. Don't you? But when he whoop you with love. Can I get a witness? Sometimes guilt is enough. Isn't it? Boy, oh, boy, boy, somebody, boy got quiet in here. So get out real quiet.
Preach, don't keep up.
Gotta close. I gotta close. Jesus, even though scripture says he was tempted, yet he did not surrender to those temptations. My role model, man. He was willing to go to the cross. He was willing to suffer. For what? Nothing. We all have sin. He died for us. We deserve to die, but he said, I love you enough to die in your place. That's a real man. Isn't that right? Somebody that's willing to die for you, even though you deserve the death penalty. Jesus said when he was on the cross, he began to pray.
Yes.
Amen. He began to pray for his enemies. He said, weep not for me. I'm dying.
Yeah.
I've been brutalized. I've been beat up. Jesus had been brutalized.
Yeah.
They beat him down. Jesus was bloody. Can I get a witness with that?
Yes.
They beat Jesus up so bad.
Yes.
Then they made him to his own cross.
Yes.
Can I witness?
Yes.
Now Jesus had the power to say, look, I'm going to call y'all. I can get y'all off me easy. Because I'm the Son of God. But he was willing to suffer for all men.
That's right.
Can I get a witness in here? I learned this. I got close. Brother Love, I learned this, Brother Love. I learned this. Jesus was up there praying on that cross. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. We got to pray for our children like that.
Yeah.
We got to pray for our neighbors. We got to pray for our president.
Yeah.
We got to pray for our country.
Yeah. Yeah.
We got to pray for people that's stone crazy right now.
Yeah.
We got to pray.
Yeah.
Pray for people that's trying to kill us.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness? It's hard. Don't think it's easy. It's hard. I'll tell anybody. I'm very retaliatory.
Right.
And I shouldn't be.
I know, right?
But there are times when I do retaliate.
Yes, forgive me, Lord.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
I'm going to say that. I'm going to jump back into it. Because I remember there was a preacher, you know, that said something to me. And I didn't like it. Next time he spoke, I didn't speak. And I said, he better not say nothing to me.
Because
I'm going to hurt his feelings.
Yes.
And I know I shouldn't be like that, but Lord, help me. I don't mean to be retaliatory type. Lord, let us know. We got to get a handle on that. We can't act like they act. We can't do what they do. We can't mess up like they mess up. We got to be better than them. on the fight. Ain't God a good God? Watch this. I learned this, bro. Love. I learned this.
When Jesus was praying, what did that tell you?
A praying man is a powerful man. A praying man is a powerful man. And I seen a t-shirt, and that's true. It says, real men love Jesus. Real man. I love me some Jesus now. Can I get a witness? Ain't God a good God? Because prayer changes the world. Prayer can change attitudes. Prayer can change marriages. Prayer can change relationships. Prayer can change the world. So real men, we got to pray. Because a praying man, tell somebody a praying man, is a powerful man. Because it keeps you in check. And it keeps you in the realm of the Holy Spirit. Isn't that right? See, the Holy Spirit can keep you in check. So some days we're strong at it. Some days I'm like, some days we got a lot of courage and we got a lot of boldness when we need. Then some days we take a lot of crap when we should. Sometimes we need to get people told and let them know, no, that ain't right. Don't you do that. Can I get a witness in there? Sometimes we gotta let people know that we are real for justice. We don't just be allow people to just treat us any kind of way. Oh no, that ain't gonna happen. Can I get a witness in here? I ain't gonna be no whim now, no. I'm all me. Can I get a witness in here? Gotta close. Prayer made Jesus strong enough to lay down life. Then on the third day, he picked it up again. Then he says, guess what God has given me? I ain't got to worry about my flesh no more because I got to glorify. He says, all power is given unto me. In my conclusion, I'm still learning how to be a real man. Still learning that I need to stay close. I'm still need to understand what a real man look like. In my text, my text said in Jeremiah, Jeremiah said, blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord, whose hope the Lord is. What that means is God is saying, if I'm going to be successful as a man and I'm going to fulfill my destiny, then one thing that I got to do is put my faith in him regardless of what happened and put my trust in him. Trusting God is hard.
Yes, it is.
It is hard. Because we're living in a physical world. And there are times we want to see and God says, I ain't showing you nothing. You just got to trust me. Then there are times you be wanting stuff. I want this. I want that. I want this. I want that. And if you ain't careful, you'll be working so much overtime, you ain't going to have time to do nothing. You ain't got time to pray. Can I get a witness? Sometimes God said, guess what? I'm going to give you that, but you got to wait. Can I get a witness? Look at things that's important. Can I get a witness? What's important? Being gone all the time? Working all the time, read that said it is, I can identify myself.
Yes, you can.
Or giving God some of your time.
Right.
building up the loved ones that God then gave you to build up. Can I get a witness? Because there are times we can give people inferiority complexes. I make sure Bethany says, Catherine, most of you. I want to give them stuff when they were love, when they would be good girls. Because I know that, guess what? I know it's going to be some little boy that's going to want to impress them. We've always had new cars. Amen. We've always had new cars. Even though they were General Motors cars. I ain't going to say nothing about General Motors. I know they're watching. We've always had new cars. We've always had nice. Now, make sure they had nice clothes. Because I don't know, some little boy coming up saying, with a diamond and necklace and all that and nice car, and they amen. If you marry one of them, you're going to earn it. You got to come more with stuff. You got to come with a little Jesus too. Can I get a win? Oh boy. Amen. I always tell men, spoil your daughters. In other words, give them rings, give them diamonds, be in love, reward them, give them stuff so that they don't be knocked off their feet when some little boy come along with some bling bling on. They just can I get away? Man, I'm trying to do better. I don't want to mess up nobody. I done messed up folk. I know I have. I'm trying not to mess up nobody else. I'm trying. Paul asked me, I'm trying not to mess up nobody. Are you trying not to mess up nobody else too? I'm trying to do better. Not just for me. Not just for me, but for others. Yeah. Jesus was thinking about others.
Yeah. That's all
he did. And we got to pray because many of us are capable on any given day. We're capable of what? Malfunction. Somebody said the word about that malfunction. Close, real man, real man. David was a real man. I like David. I can relate to David. See, I have to personalize it because David is a lot like he was human.
That's right.
Amen. And David had his issues. David had a lot of battles and trials. But David says, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all of my fears. They that wait upon the Lord. David says, the Lord is my. David had a lot of stuff that went on. Yet he was human and God, he malfunctioned and sinned and God forgave him. But David was a real man.
Yes, he did.
David did repent. I heard that word. He did. He was a real man. And he surrounded himself. Watch this. I am clothing. David surrounded himself with real men.
There you go.
See, when I say real men, David had mighty men. It was 33 of them. It might be 30, 33. They were mighty. Those men would do whatever was necessary to make the kingdom safe for themselves because they believed in the true and the living God, and they was willing to put themselves on the line and sacrifice everything because they had faith in God. Amen. We got to be willing to put ourselves on the line.
Exactly.
Because guess what? Somebody can go astray if I mess up.
Right.
Yes.
Yes.
Lord help me.
Say yes.
So the scripture says David was a man after God's own heart. Yet God loved him even though he had his issues.
Yeah.
See, one thing that I love about my God.
Well, come on.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. That he already knows. That we will malfunction. Can I get a witness? I'm so glad that God sent Jesus to live among us.
I know.
Can I get a witness? I'm so glad Jesus came to fix all of my problems. Can I get a witness? Yes, he says to you and me, cast all of your cares upon him. Yes, for he cares about you, and he cares about me. That is good news. Yes, because he cares, I've learned he will be a father for a fatherless child. Ain't God a good God?
Yes, he will.
Yes, he is. My daddy wasn't in my house, but Jesus was right there. Can I get a witness? I'm so glad that Jesus was in the house. I know here's a lot of single mamas that's right here, and a lot of real men that ran, a lot of the playboys that ran away from you. But that's all right, as long as you got King Jesus, you don't need nobody else. Can I get a witness? He raises fatherless cheering. He raises orphans, sons and daughters. Yes, I'm so glad he adopted me. Yes, he did. David said, if it had not been for the law on my side, where would I be? Yes, but Jesus has been right there. Can I get a witness? When I fell down, Jesus picked me up and carried me. Can I get a witness? Ain't God a good God? When I didn't understand about this, that, and the other, Jesus, I'm talking about Jesus. Jesus, he gave me wisdom. He gave me knowledge. Yeah. Gave me some understanding. I learned to lean. I learned to depend on Jesus. He's the best father. He's the best lover. He's the best giver. He's the best man. He's the only true and living God. You can count on him. Anybody here say, I can count on him?